Once that's the case with these two guys, I'm going to switch to more sensitive gauges. I know that this whole system will blow at 5,400 PSI, the main pressure relief. And if the schematics are wrong or my brain is wrong, I don't want to end up blowing expensive gauges. So I've got these cheap 5,000 PSI gauges, and I'm hoping when I walk out, the needle's just going to be up there. Then I'll switch to more sensitive gauges. But what I'm looking for is equal pressures in the upper pilot and the lower pilot with these guys here capped with these hydraulic caps. Okay, so we have equal pilot pressures on the swash plates, and what I'm looking for is uneven pressure with the main pumps. So this nipple here is for the upper pump here, 5,000 PSI, 5,400 actually, and the lower pump, which is here. So we have lower, here, upper, which is here. Okay. Now this here, this third guy, pilot signal, this has nothing to do with this line and this line. This pilot signal is the actual, for real, pilot line. I'm calling these pilot signals because I don't have a better name for them, but they're really the bleed signal, balancing swash plate signal, or something like that. I don't know why I just made that up. But this guy, which has already been thoroughly tested, is this pilot system that sends pilot signals to control all the different valve assemblies and buckets and tracks and all that. All that is fine. So all I'm hoping for is even numbers when these two hoses are blocked, even number on this, even number on this. This guy's gonna be blocked. These two gauges are even. And that eventually signals a no problem with the system in there. And then from there we get uneven pressures here. And then from there I will be taking this guy apart. All this for that. And I'm hoping that's gonna be the problem. All right, we're gonna find out.